What is up, everybody? Elohim here, and welcome back to Mine Colony's Interdimensional Adventure. I actually thought about shortening the name of this, but decided against it because later on I might just try like a series just with mostly the Mine Colonies. But as you can see, we have been very busy. Got some village breeding here, easy villager mod, iron farm, a wheat farm, a carrot farm, the only we have explored. I was thinking about moving the base from here to somewhere else for when we started doing the mine colony stuff, but when I came back here, I was like, actually, I kind of like this. So, today, okay, those chests are breeding my cows. Yeah, actually, I got plenty of wood, so. Today, I want to get started on, and we're starting to run out of room in here. We've got to get started on this. I want to start my colonies. We need to use that. Now I was going to do what is it called? Oh yeah, steampunk. I was gonna set up like a steampunk mine colony, but I don't think I have enough experience with the mod yet, so we're gonna hold off on that. Let me clear some more. Yeah, thought so. Let me clear some more of that out too. But I wanted to get started with this. Where to put it up at? I guess over here. Has this got enough room? Oh, there we go. Now, let's see. Ooh, birch. No. Let's see. Now, first, I want to check something. No. Okay. Went into a test world to look at some of these. And I saw one that had, that it was for beginners. I was like, you know, let's do that one because, honestly, we're a beginner. No, I don't want birch. Heck, don't want birch. Not a fan of how birch looks, so I guess that was the one I saw too. No, here's colonies. Don't want seasonal. Yeah, let's do that. Oh, we need to go sleep. Sorry, I don't know what's up. It seems like night comes really freaking quick. There we go. Let's go take a look at this. What do we have here? What do we have here? mean, this isn't a bad setup. I think I have to have those. Let's see. Yeah, that's what I thought. Okay, so let's see. These blocks right here in the way. Up over here we need. Is that good enough? No. There's some more blocks missing here. The one problem I thought about over here is that it's so hilly, and the tutorial I watched, because I did watch a tutorial on this, it was talking about, you know, it's better to not have it be a hilly area, but, yeah, I think we can deal with it. Key thing is I do plan on I do figure we'll eventually tear at least these down and eventually those down. So yeah. Let's see what all we get in here. I don't know what that's for. Saplings, that's cool. Composter. Food. Do you have a use for those? Nice. Do you kind of want to fill this? The point in having a campfire without that is a cool looking door. Got a bed in here. Some bookshelves. Lectern. That'll be nice to have. It's all the crops. I don't think it is. Hi, Mr. Scarecrow. Outside the colony. Okay. We need to this is use this blah blah blah. I want to put this over here, I think. Probably gonna have to lower this down. Okay with this, cause yeah. Oh, don't be rubber banding on me. I don't know how big of a building this is gonna be, so yeah. I should probably take this place down too. Let's find out. Fundamentals, Town Hall. What does this place look like? We need all this emptied out. I'm not sure what these blocks mean. Where's the front door? The front door's there. So I do want to... That's gonna be big. Somewhere in water. I want that to be on the side facing that way. This is complicated. Okay, so this is going to take a lot of work. Okay. Okay. So yeah, this thing's huge, even at first level. Whoa. So let's clear some more out, I guess. Oh, you should, I think, tell me. I think it's when I do click it, I think it's going to tell me what we need, like, removed. I'm gonna cut all the way back to here, though. Good thing I have a good iron. There is a lot of this I will end up doing off camera. Because, well, to be honest, I don't have a lot of time to get on. A big thing of why I didn't, another big reason why I didn't choose steampunk is quite simply, I went in a test world to see how it would look. And the supply camp had a message of how it can take, like, that one can, the buildings in that one can take 15-ish hours of real world time, and I don't have that much time to hop on here during the week. I kind of get to get on here like 2 or 3 days a week, and that's really about it anymore because of work, and I need another shovel. Get a shovel and sleep. But because of that, I don't have that kind of time. Sticks. Got the bones for a very specific reason on me. I keep seeing wolves and I'd like to tame one. Now we're going to keep the dirt in case we need it. I am intrigued to see, you know, what all we can do with the Mine Colonies mod, because it looks, from the couple tutorials I saw, it looks really fun. I don't want to take this out. Hate breaking campfires, but I do what you gotta do. Here. Now the red squirrel on the map, which is one, is an area I've claimed. Claimed it because I'm able to keep some of it chunked. So, like, that way my iron farm stays chunked. If you, I don't know if y'all saw, in previous series I've talked about, you know, backpack mods. This mod pack has my favorite backpack mod. That one. This is grindy. I look forward to having people who can build for me. That's gonna be interesting. But the tutorial I did also, the guy showed how you can create your own buildings in creative and import them into the Minecraft, which I think is pretty cool. This way with all this dirt if you need to build up an area. Definitely be handy. Up until this point I didn't have a lot of dirt. I actually haven't done a lot of mining either. I went down to some redstone, so I can make these villager stuff in the back. Really been it up. I think I did like the one mining trip, and it was in that mountain over there. I have explored the world a little bit. Again, nothing too great. Nothing that I was like, yeah, I like that better than where we already are. But I have seen a lot of stuff that's going to become getting through, like evil craft and all that. But I want to get this mod, the mine colonies, going, because apparently it can be time consuming and grindy. And the sooner I get that started, the better, because I can work on the grindy stuff off camera, and it gives me something to do when I do get to hop on. Finding out what supplies I need and get them. Not far, we are full, so. A little bit more, and then we can see what we need to do next. I have a feeling we're going to have to do a lot more digging throughout the series, but hey, it is what it is. Yeah, this is Minecraft, and crafting and digging is the things you do. And besides, later we'll get better ways of doing that anyway. Seeds are so annoying. I actually have an idea for this. If it'll work. Now I put these up. We're gonna try. Nope. So then we just do this the old-fashioned way then. And I have vein mined the roof off of that building then. I guess it was because it was world spawned with the tree touching it. We saw how big that place was. We're going to need to clear out some. I was already prepared to let these buildings go, so we'll let them go. How is everybody doing, by the way? I'm doing pretty good. I'm working a lot. Well, I say a lot. It's really just my schedule. I'm working my scheduled shift. And it's 40 hours a week, so not bad. I'll tell you guys, I recently switched what type of work I was doing. I'm no longer doing janitorial. Oh my gosh, it is so much easier doing what I'm doing now, which is security. Working as a security guard now, so life is, work is just so much easier now. I'm not going to say where or who I work for, because I never give that information on here. But someone who's done janitorial for the better part of 20 years, it is so nice not cleaning toilets anymore. And we're up to sunset again. Luckily, I brought a bed. Yes, little green guy, go fly away. Don't know what use that thing is, but keep unlocking new recipes. I'm like, I have no clue what that is. Glad I found a waystone while I was out looking around. Oh, dude, don't get in front of me or I will end up hitting you. And that is not going to make either one of us happy. Same to you, B. Don't want to hit you. So stay out of. Suicide over there. Good to know. Oh, I said a word that shouldn't be said on here. That's right, they don't want you to say that. The squid unalived itself. I don't think that's really any better, though. Differences, but okay. Have a big enough area now. Yeah. Okay. I wanted. Yes. Quite a ways this way. And at least one more. Go here and see what we have to do. I think we're going to have to take out and build out. So we're going to keep it here. I think these mean it needs air. Needs to be air. Yeah, squid, go away. Yeah, annoy me. I hate to be clear covering up part of the water here, but This was only mildly interesting. But this pack promises to be a bit more interesting. Besides, these are good supplies to have. And it was something I knew was going to end up happening eventually, of tearing this place down. Because the buildings here are just too weirdly shaped to really be of a good use. So, do is to save time, shave the front of this building off just where we need it, and then, yeah, I think that's what's going to happen here. Shave this off to where we need it, and then I will come back off camera later and tear the whole rest of the building. Probably be the smart thing to do here. Let's break that. Break that. Alright, is that good enough? Deal with that little guy, cause they're a bit of a pain. Clear up our inventory a bit. No nearby colony found. You do not currently own a colony. Word is about newly found colonies, and the first settlers will. Cool. I did not expect that to go up there, but there it works. Now I know the dude said that. There's still some stuff here, and it let me put it in. That's pretty cool. But we're still gonna take it. Can we walk through that? Yeah, we can walk through that. Now, I know the tutorial I saw talked about you have to you're want, well, you don't have to, but you're going to want to kind of hang around until these guys are done. To make sure nobody gets killed at night. But it's not night, and I want to go over here and see if there's any wolves, because I've seen some over here. Yes. Hi. Y'all come with me. Like the size of our colony. Now, I'm not sure how long this thing is going to take for them to actually build. So, we'll have to see. Hi.
Need something?
Hello there. Yes, please. Oh. So that's that left. Alright, it's no. Oh. Okay, let's see, Okay, y'all come over here and sit down. Outside the fence area. Don't want to risk anything happening to them. I didn't mean to break that. Didn't know I could break that. Oops. I didn't have to fill that in. Yeah, I know y'all are unemployed. Okay. Mission. Citizen. Build options. Yeah, I'm fine with that. Build building. Build hut. This is a freaking town hall. Why would it need more building? Why does it need a building? Alright, guys, and welcome back. It is the next day for me. Spoiler message there. It took me many hours to figure out the workings of this colony. Mine colonies mod. So let's, real quick, I've been waiting to do this on camera. There's the new setup. There's somebody over there. So, I did spend several hours working on it. So, here is our town hall. I noticed that the tutorials, most of the ones I was watching, people were in creative, and therefore they were able to skip over some stuff. Welcome to our town hall. Next door to that is our first builder's hut. We have like at least three of these now. This is a residence. This is a guard tower. We have our wood cutting guy. It's our storage building, which I'm still figuring this out. Another builder thing back there is another guard tower, because if you build guard towers near the borders of your area, see the white on the map, it expands your area. We gotta get this builder working on their stuff. Here's what all we need to give them. And once we give them all of that, they will start working on our guard tower. Over here we have a tavern, which is how you get one of the ways to get new people into your place. Also has four beds in it, which is nice. This is a alternate guard tower, which I wanted to see what that looked like. Resident build tower. This is going to be a university. I'm going to have to end up giving them probably some more tools here soon. They work out of that place. Of course, we have our supply camp that we started with. This is a mining guy. Probably gonna need more supplies. It's super quick. Now, there is still a lot of stuff I've got to learn on here, like the storage building, the warehouse, has a I gotta try to say this word right. Courier hut in it, and that's these. I can't find a thing in the building thing for building a courier's hut, so I'm not sure how that works. So we will have to look into that. I need some more residents up so that I can get more people to work in all the buildings.
I'll take care of it.
Okay, good for you.
Hi.
You need 1 to 10 oak ladders. Okay, cool. I'll get them for you. Now, eventually, I'll have people making everything for me, and then the couriers will deliver them. And we've got plenty of ladders. Let's go give them to this guy so that he can continue mining for us.
What can I do for you?
Are you happy now? Will you go back to work now? Yep, here he goes. Now, sadly, everybody is only using up to, like, they say wood to gold, but they want stone at least. So, yeah. But we have been very busy. I'm going to continue working on this. Like, we need to get the university over there built. Because then we can research stuff to get more stuff. Funny side note is, you see the water down there. There is a iron golem down there somewhere. So I got tired of bringing him out of it. Hello.
What's it today then?
Big thing we need this for is to be able to build a hospital. But they do take time to in the building of stuff. So much time. But, the tavern, there's nobody here right now, which is kind of annoying, but it is what it is. this is where wanderers will come and stay for a time, and then they we can hire them if we have a place for them to live, which is why we need residencies. We need to upgrade stuff. Like, I need to get this place upgraded to rank 2. We can upgrade that. I just hope it's not bad. And here's the thing. It's going to sit there and keep saying that until we call worker. Will you work on it? You're not busy. Yeah, there we go. Now he'll tell us what we need. We need ladders, acacia planks, bench saw, chiseled stone, cobble. Only 3 cobblestone. That's not bad. But look, we're starting to get into some interesting blocks. Why he needs dandelion, I don't know. Jack-o'-lantern. But really, all of this is doable so far. The acacia, I've got some saplings. Tall grass. Oh, I'm not sure how to get tall grass. I will have to look into that. Yeah, we'll get you going. How much of that dirt do you actually need? 4.
Hi.
We'll get stuff he needs. But I didn't want to sit here and just... Because I spent like another hour after the last section of the recording y'all saw. In the recording. I sat here for like another hour with the recording, trying to figure out how the heck to get things to do with, I mean, that. Alright. And now I've got to get him going. I'll make that another way. The gravel reminded me. I did branch out into another mod to assist with gathering of the resources. And that is the create mod that I use for making gravel. And of course, we have our slow progression of freaking cobblestone. Sorry, brain fart, on what that was called. Get some gravel. We'll grab the gravel that we have. Take it with us over there. I have been exploring as well, looking for supplies, because I don't have any reliable way of getting wood right now. Or string, so we are going to have to fix that. These builder's huts seem to always need some weird block. Now we also have expanded into Project E, which, for those of you who are familiar with the mod pack, no, it does not come with the mod pack. I did add that for the ease of what it allows. I hate those crows. They are not. Okay. But it's literally, most of the mine colony stuff I think I'm going to be doing off camera, because it's really just a lot of running back and forth at this point. Until I get the couriers up working. Yeah. Do that. intrigued to see what this second tier of this place is going to look like. But that is all the time I have for recording right now. I do, like I said, I'm going to work on this off camera mostly. At least I get the couriers up. And then in the next episode, we'll work on something else, most likely. But I've also got to get to work on up on my acacia saplings. I will, when I get done with this tonight, I've got to work on stuff for the D&D campaign that we try to do weekly. So that does, you know, cut into my recording time. So I do got to make some time for that. There they are. I think I have some more over in the supply can. We'll see. Let's go check. Now, right now, none of my colony people are really happy. And that is because, well, quite frankly, I'm not meeting most of their needs. Which sucks, but it is what it is. And once I get a few things sorted out in the mod, we will be able to do some of it. I do want to thank everybody for watching, though. I hope you have enjoyed what you saw here, and I will see you in the next video. Bye, guys.